Okay. Hello, welcome back to Thing 4. So, we'll be playing in hard mode. And so, have gone through all the achievements you can get in normal mode, but there are still a few left I will go over as well, which is completing hard mode, which is an achievement, and then also getting a 100% complete achievement, I guess, if that makes sense. So the plan is, let's go to level select, go to the armory. So we'll just go through a few things. We might just get rid of this for now. And so we have different pistols you can get, other weapons. So if you want to, in the beginning of hard mode, you can go in here and get some powerful weapons. We're just in the beginning. I just wanted to kind of show you where the armory is, and we don't have to. I think I will choose not to because I like the challenge. So we're gonna go ahead and pick up weapons along the way when we go through the game. So for one exception being this, which is kind of a default, well, not default, but the thing you have for unlock from last time. So if you want to learn how to unlock the sword, you'll have to see the last video. But anyways, should be fine as is. So how to go to hard mode? Go to options and then select hard mode on. When you do that, you'll see something disappear. That's the level select. So some things to know about for hard mode. You cannot pause. I think I've tried it before, and I don't really remember being able to, so there's that. And also, you also have to start over if you die, so you can't go to any levels, since there's no level select. I already said it sounded like I'm repeating myself, but, yeah. So, in hard mode, let's go back. So in hard mode, just something real quick to know about as well. The enemies will do more damage, and the bosses will also be more dangerous. I think we're ready to go. So, what we're gonna do is continue game. Do a new game, we'll erase all data, so we don't want to do that. So, yeah. Alright. Here we go. It's been hours, as if the Hades prototype wasn't enough trouble. Now I'm stuck in this mess. Why did I have to be created? Is all of this suffering really just for the sake of a more potent weapon? How come it had to be me that was created for this? It's only been a couple days since it all began, trapped in my cell, waiting to be evaluated for my abilities. Muscle enhancers, behavioral suppressants, mind control. Genetic purification. Oh, goodness. Test for effectiveness. Repeat until it works. I was designed to kill, and that's what I did. Huh. That systems corp hadn't anticipated that it would all work so well. Poseidon was nothing but a bump in the road. I had finally gotten my first taste of freedom. I had escaped my containment cell and seen the real world, outside for the first time. It was then that I knew that I had to pave my own way. I couldn't be slave to some demented corporate regiments. Of course, this was the very last thing Systems Corp had in mind for me. They needed to recover their investment. They couldn't let me go, nor could they let me live. Because of their persistence, there is no running from the fight. They'll send everything they have, no matter how many people die. My genes are too valuable, and their secret is too vital. So, it seems like this is an experiment of some kind. Hopefully this isn't too many spoilers, but yeah. They're trying to get the experiment back, basically. I think that that's kind of self-explanatory, though. Yeah. They've even gone so far as to send other experiments after me. The only way to end this is to go to the top and eliminate whoever is in control of all of this insanity. If I ever make it out of this containment chamber. The energy core that powered the Hades prototype. They stopped using these because they were too unstable and explosive. Looks like I may have a way out of here after all. I'll have my revenge on whoever created me. Nothing is going to stop me. Okay, so we're going to begin. So, I'm going to be careful. Try not to take too much damage. New area is open already. Alright, so I'm gonna watch out for those other kinds of, what are those called? These are just regular pistols, but I'm worried about that right there. The, magnums. Yeah, those can hurt a lot. Woo! Alright. I think we got both kinds of weapons. Okay. Whew. I need quite a bit of shots to kill the enemy. It seems like they're a lot tougher. Yes. He's trying to get some kind of a machine gun. I don't know if it was solid or not, but okay. The important thing is staying alive, because you don't want to have to start over from the beginning. Alright, we have a machine gun. Okay. Never safe when we're ducking. You have to watch your health, because sometimes you will get hit by some kind of weapon that's really powerful, perhaps, so you should be careful. Let's go pick that up. I'm not sure if that's what we're looking for, but that's okay. Alright, new area open. Let's continue. Alright. Combination of melee and firearm attacks. Open. Ooh. Oh! Alright. Alright, almost there. Except the next place is the elevator. This, you could stay here if you'd like to, or in the middle of the elevator, so either way is fine, really. Doesn't look like we're picking up a lot of ammo, though, which, this is a bummer too, probably way too much really ammo. Okay. Should be able to pick up some better weapons later on. We'll still get some of the ammo from here in a bit, so. I would say this is the safest thing to do now. I think I would probably recommend using the safest strategies in order to complete this challenge, so yeah. Of course, it's up to you, so. I mean, really, I didn't even go to the armory for any extra weapons, so. I guess, yeah, if you're doing this for the first time, maybe go ahead and go to the armory and get, like, some nice weapons to start with. The thing is, you might run out of ammo later on and find better weapons along the way as well, or some more ammo and weapons. And really, it doesn't matter too much, I think, in my opinion, but yeah, anyways, what am I doing? I think I'm rambling a lot about this semester. Oh, okay. So we have an area open, alright. Let's see what lies ahead. Okay, so if you want to, you can go back up the stairs. You won't be spawning as much there if you did, do get too much damage. So. Alright. And yeah, again, I guess I didn't mention this before, but, doing like double jumps or just backwards jumps, those are the best. You should stick to that, I think. Dodging can be useful as well, but be careful about dodging, I would say. Because then you're kind of a sitting target, so keep moving. It's always good to keep moving. Alright, alright. Anyways, your enemies here. Alright, so next area is like a small tunnel. So go ahead and see what else you need to unlock. So do you get the exit unlocked? So I would say you probably shouldn't go to where I'm going, because if you go too far in the tunnel, it could get overwhelmed by all the enemies. It's a very close space, so I would say stay out in the open here or above, whichever one you would prefer. Yeah, if you're wondering why I'm not taking so much damage doing this, I think it's because I've kind of played through the game, I'm a bit more skilled at it, so. But if you're playing it for the first time and you just begin hard work early, then yes, going to the platforms above can give you an advantage and help you take less damage, so. Yeah, keep that in mind, I guess. What weapons do we have? A couple different things, okay. Like they're kind of pumpkins, but right. Oh, okay. Continue. Right. Okay. So we should have be able to find a secret area below. Okay. So what we need to do is get the key card. We have already gone over this in the previous video, but I will again in case you see this for the first time. So. And because this is important, you should get a key card to the left. I will go ahead and do that now. And there should be some secret weapons to this direction. I do like using these, and I will go ahead and get them, because why not? Alright. Should I though? You know what, on second thought, I don't need to this time, but I did unlock the area just to show you. So if you are having trouble and you run out of ammo and you need a little help, you can go there and get some extra weapons. But for now, I think we're good. We have some ammo we collected from enemies and stuff. Yeah. Alright, let's continue. Okay. So there's something below. Yes. Alright, so if you want to, you can go up here to some of the platforms above for cover in case you take a lot of damage. Seems like I'm doing fine though, so let's go ahead and grab a few of these enemies. But may as well use it, I guess. Looks like we take picking up the same kind of ammo for something else. I'm not quite sure what happened there, but that's okay. Alright. I think one of the enemies has a shotgun. I don't see them. Alright, shooting at us. Should be careful. Don't want to take too much damage. Most of them can find us, so. And yeah, I guess staying still for too long is a bad idea. Not good. Could lead to death, perhaps. Yes. So. How many enemies do we have to go through? Let's see. I don't really know if these will work quite well enough, but. Oh! So it's kind of hard to shoot them while you're jumping because they will jump too, so that's why I like melee for that reason, but. Took a little bit of damage there. Alright. Hey. Okay. Took a bit of damage there. So, yeah. Again, if you're having trouble with taking too much damage, you can't go there. Okay, so there will be a lot of enemies. You're going to want to stay in the center. Alright. And don't panic like I did the last time I played the game. You've seen the video before. Alright, if you do take too much damage, again, just do this. Try to practice this, but this is important. Jumping like so will save your life, so. You can go back to the middle again if you'd like after this, if you can get them to stop moving around so much, which I do, they have a bit of trouble, it seems, so. Try using a melee weapon here. Didn't expect that to happen so much early on. That much damage was quite near fatal, I would say. So, maybe you should be careful about that for sure. We didn't even have any grenade launchers as far as I saw, really, so... this elevator, you know, I wouldn't say this is high risk, really, but it seems like we bit unlucky there. Now, elevator coming up after this later on, when enemies have grenade launchers, it is what is much more dangerous. Okay. I don't want to risk it too much, though. I'm not going to go back to the middle for now. So, yeah. Alright. There we go. Looks like I have a good amount of ammo. Yeah. Alright. Let's continue. Okay. Alright, so now we're in offices. This is when you will see the game. I'm gonna use to have grenade launchers quite soon, so I should be trying to steer clear of those kinds of weapons because while they may damage other enemies around because of the blast radius, they also could damage you even if you use them yourself, so quite dangerous. Either your hands or the enemy's hands really, so yeah. I have used them before. They are helpful, but I don't prefer to use them. I have a choice often, so... Don't see any grenade launchers at the moment, but... Let's see. Okay, I guess we can continue now. Alright. Ooh! And also, shotguns become much more powerful, especially at close range. Be careful about that, so... Ooh. Oh, okay. That was close. See, even a magnum pistol thing, that could still do a lot of damage, so very careful about that. And yeah, even though it was doing double jumps and backflips, like, so, I still took a lot of damage there. I didn't notice that, so. Yeah, sometimes that may not save you, so you really do need to keep your distance from certain enemies, especially. In mind what kind of weapons they have as well, so, and watch your back as well. Sometimes an enemy will come up behind you, and so you need to be careful about that. Ooh. All right. Here are the ammo. Yes, more weapons you can use. Now, I would keep my distance, and hopefully it won't be a problem after a while. Okay. So you can hear in the background, they just launched a few grenades, possibly killing some enemies for us, but also, may still be alive, so I don't really think I could tell right now. Okay. Too close to that shotgun, I will say. That or something else. Oh, there's another shotgun. Okay. Alright. Okay, let's try to keep our distance as much as we can, as I'm not able to very well. get away from me! Oh, that shotgun! Oh my goodness. Okay, okay, we're good, we're good. Just open! What is happening? Okay, okay. Yeah, that was, interesting. now I can do that with the sword, okay. Oh, sorry, let me handle this. Oh, there's another enemy. Was I deflecting bullets with the sword? I don't know. Looks like you made it out of the holding cell after all. And not without a staggering death toll at that. But, as you can see, this must come to an end. You didn't bring enough firepower. We'll see. Kill him. Oh no. Got to escape. Alright. Looks like we made it. It's time to die, 154. Okay, so here, before we finish the dialogue there, this is going to be the first boss fight. There are two throughout the game, so later on we'll get to the second one, but for now, I want to know for this one is, first, the helicopter will drop bombs, and we'll be in a car below. You have to dodge them, so, it's not too hard, they are a bit slow, so you really just have to go either to the left or the right, and then, what you have to do is the damage to back up the helicopter, basically, and once it's a bit damaged, you'll start to have a secondary attack, or so I think like a primary attack. But then it's unlocked after that, it will start trying to shoot you with this machine gun. So you have to dodge both things. I will show you how to do that. And yeah, okay. You can't run anymore. Oh, going to need a bigger gun. Oh, alright, so. Alright, here we are. You can see it start to drop grenades like that, or bombs, perhaps. Yeah. So, keep in mind where the helicopters go as well. You may not always be able to dodge left or right. It really depends. So, yeah. Right. And once it's more damaged, the machine gun will shoot faster. So, be careful of that. Alright, so. No, no machine gun yet, but it should be soon. Okay. Ooh! Okay, a lot of damage there, let's be careful. Alright, machine gun. A lot of damage there. Alright. Just try to be careful. Alright. Ooh! Oh, alright. Oh! Careful! Alright. Okay, I'm gonna concentrate. creeping up yet?
Woo!
Yes. Alright. We did it. 153 is dead. Huh. At least that's one problem out of the way. Looks like System Corp's secret genetics lab isn't far from here. That's where I'll be. Alright. So, is it picked up a new weapon? Let's pick that up again. Oh, I dropped that. Alright, so this can be handy. And yeah, let's continue. Alright. Okay, we should come up to an area we can farm for a bit of ammo. We'd like to for a minute. Okay. This is where I'm locked, so you need to go to the far left, below. So that's what we're going to do. Okay. Ooh, there's a grenade launcher. I need to be careful. Ooh, it's a triple grenade launcher. Okay. Get rid of that enemy. Ooh, okay. Need to get rid of that. Oh, maybe there's been a single grenade launcher. Missed the bin. Freaked out a little bit. Anyways, may as well use this, I guess. But after this, we should be able to, below here. Sometimes you can't stay in one place, but right now, I don't think that we're able to since there's just so many enemies everywhere. So I think we're going to have to deal with that. Alright. That's a grenade launcher. Alright. Oh. Alright, looks like they fall down here. Don't know. Oh. Oh, that did so much damage. Yes. Let's get out of here. Again, don't get too close to the shotgun. That is quite dangerous. That's what it seems like I did accidentally. Ooh. Ooh. Alright. Ooh. Alright. That's a grenade launcher! Woo! Alright, we're good. Okay. It's okay with some kind of shotgun, yes. Woo! Alright. Oh, it's not gonna hit at me. Okay. Alright. Get rid of that. Ooh! Alright. See if the door still hasn't opened yet. Okay, now it's open. Let's get out of here. Oh, goodness, there's a lot of chaos going on. Okay. Alright. Ooh! Oh, okay, let's get out of here. Oh, goodness. Huh. Okay, alright, open. Okay, let's be careful. Alright. 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 Alright, we're gonna lock this area, so let's try to do that. Alright, let's get out of here. Alright. So, there are some more weapons there ahead. I'll show you how to get them if you want to. So, there we go, new area open. I think we're good, but there's the key card to the right, similar to, I think, another room somewhere, perhaps. So yeah, here are the weapons, which you can get if you'd like to, some laser rifles, and whatever the other one is, but, you know, it's up to you, you don't have to. I think I'll choose not to this time. Yeah, it's purely for the challenge of it, really. So, anyways. But yeah, I would recommend getting those if you are having trouble with finding enough ammo, and if you really do want to, that's fine. So, anyways, soon we should come up to, oh, not yet, but there will be the zombies later on, so, okay. One of the enemies has a shotgun. Oh! Okay. Alright. Oh, alright. Let's get out of here. So you gotta lock the door, so you need to kill enough enemies to do that, so... Ooh. Pick up here. Might go as well. Alright. Actually, I think the entrance should be here. Alright, let's try to pick that up. That'll help a little bit. Whew. Okay, we can get through here, thankfully. Alright. Okay. So, this is the easy part. Now, be mindful of where the zombies are when you go down there, because their melee attacks do a lot of damage. You do not want to get hit by that, so it's to jump over them. And if you have no ammo, which it looks like is their situation, you should use melee, but keep your distance. It's important to do that, so... Alright. And it seems like they're faster and stronger in this difficulty as well, so... Let's say be quite careful here. Alright. Ooh, we do take quite a bit of damage, don't we? Alright. So again, I will press P. Okay, so listen, we can pause. So I will go ahead and just say, yeah, you can pause the game in this difficulty. I just did to try to see if I can or not. Apparently you can, for some reason. But I'll try not to. It's just a test, but... Okay, anyways. That is interesting. So, other than that, what I do know for sure is that you cannot select whatever level you would like. You have to, like, start over from the beginning. Okay. Alright, I need to concentrate. It's getting quite a bit of damage there from... Yes, for these zombies. Okay. Ooh. Ooh. Yeah, it's been quick for sure. Yeah. Ooh. Oh, okay. Yeah, again, watch what's in front and behind you, basically, because you don't know if there's gonna be one behind. You seem to spawn from anywhere, really. Yeah, look for gaps between the zombies. You can jump between if you have to, because blind jumping wherever might not actually work very well, so. I guess really just be mindful of your surroundings. That's what my advice is, so. Okay. Woo! A lot of damage done. Alright. Let's try not to risk it too much, really. I'm keeping alert, so part two. Oh, goodness. Okay. Woo! Oh, that was close. That was so close. Okay, we're still okay. We're still okay. Okay. Goodness! Yeah, there's no kidding how much damage they can do if you're not careful. Oh my goodness, that was close. We're okay, we're still alive. Yeah, yeah, okay. Oh, kind of thought that might happen. Oh, okay. Oh, no, no. Oh, no. Oh. Okay, we're good, we're good. Oh, man. Alright. Okay, it's a little too close for me. Okay. Yeah. So secret weapons you can get, like, I will show you where they are as well. So basically just above, you know, grab the key card. And you can go ahead and do that. Right now I don't have ammo. So we could do this, but I'll just go ahead and show you the different weapons. So, and if you get this far in a game, it is okay to get these if you'd like to. This has a lot of ammo. So we could take that with us, but so also this. And then, it's like a Desert Eagle as well, which is this, which I don't prefer because, I think that the shotgun's a little more powerful. Maybe it's a little bit of ammo, but I mean, it's pretty good. This, has a lot of ammo, it's a little inaccurate, so we could do that if we want to, but I think we'll be fine. Yeah. I would recommend taking them though, if you, you know, want to, but yeah, gonna go ahead and use melee. So okay, so up ahead, there's an open room with a lot of teleporters where enemies will drop down below. So what you could do is jump above where the teleporters are, jump from each one in case you take a lot of damage and need to recover your health. Another thing you could do is just do backflips as well. And just be aware of any grenade launchers or shotguns. Those, I think, are the worst. You don't want to stay away from those, especially. So, I think we're good. Let's go. And then after that, also, maybe I should mention this too. So after that, there will be another elevator. This one will be especially difficult. You'll have to stand in the middle. Be careful of the grenade launchers. So, if they start throwing grenades at you, try to kind of get out of the way and, you know, do that. So, yeah, and then the last boss fight after that, which I'll get to it later. So, let's go. Alright. Ooh. I thought there's a grenade launcher somewhere. Okay. Ooh. Let's try to pick up some weapons if we're able to. Ooh, took a lot of damage there. Let's also keep our distance if we're able to some extent. Okay. Where are they going? Oh. Okay. That's a grenade launcher. Alright. My first weapon, a grenade launcher. Alright. Be careful. Pick up anything. No, not yet. Alright. Okay. Alright. Right there, looks like it was pretty close to range too. Yes. Okay, ooh! Alright. Okay. Yeah, let's get up here for now. I don't want to get hit by a grenade, so I don't know how to do this, but yeah. This might be useful. Okay, I don't hear anymore right now. Let's be careful. Okay. Okay. We took a little bit of damage, okay. Yeah, so I have to be careful with that. I do think I've been a little careless there. Let's get out of here. Okay. Alright, so I try to stay in the middle, if you can see. Okay, we're not. Yeah, I think on a second thought, maybe not so much. Grenades. Okay. Yeah, we're just gonna use melee against this. Ooh, so you watch out for that. You can touch that. Ooh. Oh, there's a grenade. Oh, goodness. Alright. Oh. Oh, that was close. Okay. Oh, that's a grenade flying in the air. I guess this is something I learned about. And yeah, quite dangerous. Okay. So, Start stepping from that shotgun. That's what I'm worried about the most, really. I missed it towards everything. I think I'm doing fine. But, okay. Oh man. Looks like we're almost done. Alright. Alright, after this is the final boss. So, alright, so once you get to the final boss, if you haven't already seen the game before, and so. Yeah, basically, there are two phases. The first one is just a regular enemy walking around without any weapons, really, which may have melee attacks, I think. But, anyways, after it goes to its second phase, the boss will have spider legs, basically. You have to dodge those, so what I would do is try to, like, run away, do small dodges like this. Like, to kind of just go away. like that. And then do a double jump right when you get a corner and a wall. Jump back away from it. That has worked as well as just smaller jumps even without the double jump. Depends on the strategy. I think normally for me though, what works is a double jump. When you're at the wall, so. Okay. Yeah, I might run out of ammo, so it's okay to use a sword as well. Another thing. So, the boss also has a very powerful rifle, which does a lot of damage, so you have to keep dodging that as well as other enemies, which will be trying to attack at the same time, basically. So, I think we're ready to go. Alright. Alright. So we're gonna use Pecora behind us, so. This part's difficult, alright, so I'm gonna need some concentration for this. Yeah, triple grenade launcher is not good. Not good. Alright. Okay. Hades rifle? Don't have a lot of ammo, that's okay. Alright. Alright, so this last part you cannot survive. Alright. You can try as long as you can, but really sweat to let you know, I suppose. Okay. Well done, Project 154. You've made it all this way and fought through hell to get here. You're expecting that I'd be there, though, were you not? Normally, I would be, but given the trouble you've been causing, I thought I'd get to safer ground. So here you are. You've defeated every soldier and weapon we've thrown at you. Not to mention destroyed millions of dollars of my own investment and killed countless employees of mine. So, what happens now, then? Here I have the most powerful weapon in the world standing before me, but you're impossible to control. You've also managed to destroy nearly all of our research on you. So, I suppose the answer is obvious, then. We'll just have to try again. You've proven your genes in the field. You just need some behavioral tweaking so that our potential buyers aren't at risk. The obvious problem is that you are the sole carrier of all of our research. And more importantly, I estimate that you have no interest in returning yourself to our cause. This, however, doesn't give you the upper hand. You're just a clone. You're not even the original. You're one of hundreds of experiments that are just like you. It does seem quite depressing. We've had to toss failures just like you into the incinerator because they had minor genetic. Sorry, I don't understand that word. Defects. I think it's genetic, yeah. And whether or not you're alive or dead won't affect my business or my sentiments one bit. I'll just kill you where you stand. Oh, my engineers clean up what they need to make another. It's a bit crude, but sometimes the simplest answers are the best. Okay, so what we're going to do is to, I'll basically show you. Goodbye, 154. You'll surely prove profitable in your next life, because we're going to, like, jump, do, like, the backflips and stuff. Once we go on the floor right before the backflip, we'll try to shoot enemies that are coming from the left, alright? And then if we run out of ammo, we'll try switching to our melee attack. So basically what we'll do, we're taking quite a bit of damage. Whew. I think that we actually take damage without getting hit slowly over time. It seems interesting. Yeah, or maybe it's in my imagination. Well, anyways, Project 154 has been successfully terminated. Take Spidey's genetics and have them map his genes. Next time we won't make the same mistakes. Alright. So, we got all the achievements. So, let's go to our hard mode level select unlock. Oh, okay, so now we can do level select after that. But, anyways, let's return to the main menu. So, the one weapon we've unlocked, which I suppose is the hardest, of course. Let's go ahead and find out. Let me go to, so level select, the armory, okay? And I will show you. So, we have not used it because we have to complete all achievements in hard mode. So that's basically, all you have to do that. Let me go find it real quick. Okay, it should be the nuke. That's what it's called, the type of weapon we're trying to find. So, should be in the door to the left. And there it is. So, if you want to replay the game using that, you can. Basically, what it does, let me go ahead and show you. Alright, so, when you press the button, it fires, something. If you have to shoot a wall or a floor or some sort of thing like that, there we go. And it kills all enemies around, so, quite powerful. If you just shoot like that, it really doesn't do much, so, I mean, you have to, like, hit something. There we go. So, yeah. It's a bit overpowered, so I wouldn't prefer using that, really. Doesn't look like that's actually a weapon on the left, it's just, I can't really pick that up for some reason. Oddly enough. Anyways. Yeah, so that's everything, and, yeah, let's go back. Just because. Okay, and yeah, that's it. We finished hard mode, so, yeah, I guess that's it. I hope you enjoyed it, and yeah, I'll see you next time.